we are in our original state or natural state, the unmanifested, the nirankari. Our real state is beyond the state of names and forms and concepts of mind, energy and consciousness or emotions. It is the state of the unlimited. It is essentially who we are, the thing that does not, that awareness which does not have a name or a form. It is eternal because it is unmanifested. It is absolutely free. Absolutely, there is absolute freedom because it is the unmanifest. Because it is beyond the world of name, form, energy, consciousness. Only something which is beyond the forms and names, energy and consciousness can be in absolute freedom. Only then there can be absolute freedom, because it doesn't manifest. It is not the manifested. Moment we are the manifested, moment we identify ourselves as the manifested, we lose, there is freedom, but that is relative freedom. There cannot be an absolute freedom. Absolute freedom is only a quality of the unmanifest. Absolute peace, absolute sense of security, absolute sense of permanence, absolute sense of immortality is only the quality of the unmanifested. It is not and cannot be the quality of the manifested. So we essentially the unmanifested, and that is our natural state. And the sooner we realize this, the sooner we awaken in this, the better for us, because these qualities of permanence, of purity, of equality, these are qualities of the unmanifested. They cannot be seen or cannot be realized on the manifested plane. Manifested plane does not have these qualities. These are relative qualities in the manifested plane. There is a relative sense of permanency. There is a relative sense of security. There is a relative sense of justice, of equality. It is relative. There is no absolute, because the absolute only lies in the realm of the unmanifested, which is our essential nature and our natural state.